Hello to you all. I'm Nurit Ben, and welcome to Improvate's third international conference. It's a space for creating long-lasting connections, allowing change makers in technology and decision makers in government to make progress through innovation. Improvate is all about finding solutions and sparking collaborations that improve the quality of life for people around the world. Today, linking between Israel and Africa in a field that has everything to do with a sustainable future, agriculture. Throughout this special broadcast, we'll be hearing from ministers and ambassadors from Tanzania to Ethiopia, Gabon, South Sudan, Kenya, Angola, and the Democratic Republic of the Congo. Also with us today, executives from African organizations and food companies from Eat Fresh to the Clinton Development Initiative and the Beula Seed Company. And of course, a key pillar of all these conferences, we'll be hearing from 10 of Israel's leading agritech companies presenting tech solutions to help address major pressing challenges across Africa. Taking part today, Motes, Home Biogas, Kalant, Haifa Group, Metzer, ISM, Davik, the Volcani Center, Saffron Tech, and Agrigo. And as always, watching along with us are representatives of investment funds from around the world looking to invest in Israeli innovation. And starting us off right here in the studio, Improvate's founder and chairman, Irina Nevzlin, along with Dr. Alejandro Marabi. He is part of PepsiCo's External Innovation Global Team, leading agritech solutions as well as processing and ingredients-related initiatives. He'll be here listening to the range of African and Israeli innovators we'll hear from and looking out for potential investments. And do continue to listen because we're going to hear from several other Israeli companies and technologies. The next one coming up right now, let's hear from Kalant. They provide a holistic packaging for the marketing and assimilation of Israeli off-grid technologies among farmers in Africa. Dorit Bennett is founder and CEO of Eilat, Eilot Renewable Energy, and co-founder and chairman of Kalant Israel and its subsidiary Kalant Kenya. Dorit, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for asking me to come.
So tell us, first of all, what is the importance of creating a market and purchasing power?
Before answering your questions, I wanted just to mention that our CEO sitting in Nairobi, Omri Cohen, and my co-founder, Orit Barom Albeck, we are the triple that make this come true. So if something would go on from this event, so Omri would be the one that would lead the company in the closures. So as the SDGs shows that it's very important to improve the quality of life of farmers, smallholder farmers, water, running water, clean water, heat, cooking gas, energy, clean energy. So those basic infrastructures in off-grid solution, in off-grid areas that are most of the areas when we are looking at Africa continent. So those initial fundamental technologies can come and make a change, a huge change in the life of the farmers. This change can also save a lot of money, and this money can go to seeds, to improve the seeds, to bring water to the agro fields and so on. Most of the farmers in Kenya are cooking on charcoals. So 2% of the gas emission in the world comes from charcoals, burning charcoals. And I won't say about the health of the farmers that have to breathe this smoke all the time. So we are coming with very easy, clean, easy to deploy, a very low-tech technology that can give the solution in a day. You don't have to wait that the government will give you pipelines of water to wait to have gas or to have
the bureaucracy that often stalls everything.
The bureaucracy and all the infrastructures and all the huge money you have to invest to bring those infrastructures to the population. So we are bringing a small kit that it's a miracle. You get the kit, you get the instruction. We have a lot of demo sites. We are in the field. We are working. We have a lot of locals that are part of our company. We provide a lot of work opportunities over there, and people can see, can feel, can touch, and our magic that we can finance also. That means that we are bringing all the package where if you like the home biogas or whatever technology we are bringing, we can provide you, we make contract with the banks, We make due diligence with the banks for all technologies, and the banks give you loans, microfinance, mostly in the cooperatives, where the cooperatives know you as a farmer, and your guarantees, your supply, product supply every day. For example, we're working in a milking cooperative. So the farmer each morning comes with the milk and gives to the dairy. So the dairy has the bank, and the bank knows this farmer, and she knows that he can loan this farmer 18 payments. To pay this installment. And we had to prove it, and we proved it. And right now, even the Corona time, we're in Kenya, first year, and we're selling. We are selling technologies direct to the farmers, and the farmers are happy.
One-stop shopping, which really sounds so relevant to the problems that we keep hearing about, which are very much about small-scale farming.
Right.
So that's such a big help not to have to go through that whole bureaucracy. Why Israeli technologies? We're here obviously talking a lot about Israeli technologies. What really sets them apart in this field?
Look, Israeli technology for Africa is very good in agriculture. Because we had to struggle here in Israel a lot with hard lands and droughts and heavy hard right. water and so on. We don't know in Israel a lot over the real needs that Africans are dealing with. So we are an innovative country and we are a startup nation, but we still do not really emphasizing and seeing the needs of the African people. So something else we are doing, we are being there and see the and learning the challenges. We are bringing the challenges into Israel, and we operate a new R&D hub in the Arava Valley, where over there we are giving solution with the know-how of the Israeli industry, a very easy way to reach a product, for example. We saw there that most of the farmers bringing milk in cans, small cans on bicycles, on cars. And what happens that the milk, until he reach the dairy part of it, is not good enough.
Yeah.
It's not good enough because they don't have electricity to cool the milk. So now we are in a process operating a small cooler, a cooler system for small cans in a very unique way. I won't describe it right now. It's with the finance system, how he can buy it or rent it or lease it right. for one day to have a cool milk. It's something that in the daily life in Israel, we are not right. dealing with. So I think there is a lot of know-how in the Israeli industry, in the industry technology. And if we'll meet the needs, we can give to have a rise of many technologies can give answers to the locals.
The sky's the limit. Well, before I let you go, you've already talked quite a bit about it, but what else would you say makes your model unique for Africa in particular?
I think that we are on the ground. We are in the cooperatives. We are with the farmers. I think that we bring the finance also with us. And I think that we don't want any more donations and salvation to Africa. We want to build a market.
To build something sustainable.
That's it. So if we'll have a market, so many other Israeli technologies will go there. Because if you ask all the companies here in Israel, they will tell you they're dealing with governments. It's very hard to deal with governments. They're dealing with big initiatives in the world, bank world and so on. But they're not dealing with the market. It's very hard to build their market. And this is the challenge.
Dorit Bennett, thanks so much for being with us.
You're welcome.
Really interesting peek into the technology you do. And that is it from Improvate's Israel-Africa International Agritech Conference. We've heard today from government officials, local African companies, and from Israel's leading agritech companies about the needs of Kenya, Ethiopia, Gabon, Tanzania, South Sudan, and the Democratic Republic of the Congo, all in this crucial field of agriculture. And as you've heard, Improvate is all about access and connections, exposing Israeli tech leaders and governments to companies around the world to promote businesses whose goal is innovation. The exposure you've seen right here at this conference, that's just the first step. The next, delegations and real business connections. We want to thank you all for taking part and hope this is just the very beginning of doing business together and making technology accessible to all and improving the lives of millions across Africa. And keep an eye out for Improvate's next conference on January 21st, From Crisis to Innovation, Creating a New World. We'll be looking at the challenges and opportunities in Europe in exiting, finally, this global crisis, from medicine to transportation to tourism and education. Thanks so much for joining us, and we'll see you then.